Hello friends, welcome back to this video on analog communication. In this video, we are going to discuss the next generation method of double sideband suppressed carrier, which is the ring modulator or the chopper modulator. So here first we'll discuss the structure or the circuit of the chopper modulator or ring modulator, then we'll discuss its working, and after all we'll discuss the waveform also. So first we'll see the circuit. So in the circuit we have audio frequency input signal which is connected to a transformer. So this is my audio frequency input. I am calling it as X of T. So now it is connected with the help of a transformer. So now this is my transformer which is connected to diode. So this is my diode D1 and this is my diode D2. So these are my ideal diodes. So now the diode is again connected to a transformer. Now in between I have two sets of diode as well. So this is my diode D3 and I have one more diode. So this is my diode D4. I am considering D1, D2, D3 and D4 to be ideal diodes. So these are ideal in nature. I hope you know the working of the diodes. The diodes work as a switch. So now after that, it is connected again to a transformer, from where we can calculate the output voltage. So now here I have a capacitor for storing charge. So from the charge stored in the capacitor, we can measure the V output T. So now I hope you can understand the structure. So you must be wondering, where is the carrier? So now these transformer are center tapped transformers, so it is center tapped to the carrier. So this represents my CT. CT is my carrier. So now the working of the diode depends upon the voltage, input voltage. So I know the carrier is having very high frequency and amplitude as compared to XT. So when I compare the CT and XT, CT will have very high amplitude as well as high frequency. So I can say the diode functioning will depend upon CT only. So now I hope you remember, in my previous video also I was saying the same thing, because CT is having very high amplitude and high voltage, the diodes are working in accordance to the CT. So if a CT is supplying the voltage such that the diodes are forward biased, so the diode will become forward biased, whatever my XT would be. So now here I have the capacitor. Capacitor is used to store the charge, and from here I'll get the output voltage. So these are center tapped transformers. The center tapped transformer would give me equal voltage in the positive and the negative half. So now if I talk about the working, so I hope now you understand the structure, the components in very clear manner. So if you still have any doubt, you can put the doubt, but I hope all of the things are very clear now. So these are in the form of ring. So this is called a ring modulator. So I have four diodes. Two diodes are in forward manner and two diodes in the reverse manner. So these four diodes are in the form of a ring. So this is called a ring modulator. So I am taking these points to be A, B, C and D. So now first I'll talk about the working when XT is equal to 0 and CT is positive. I was saying the working of the diodes depend upon the amplitude and the frequency of CT. So I am taking the CT to be positive and XT to be zero. So now input is not applied. So I am removing this transformer. So we'll see this structure, what is happening to the structure when the CT is zero, when CT is positive and XT is zero. So now I remove the XT because XT was 0. So now when CT is positive, so you can see from this diagram that when it is positive, the current would flow. This is positive, this is negative. So the current will flow from here to here, here. From here it is divided in the half and half manner because it is center tapped. So half of current will travel here and here. So now it is encountering the negative terminal and it is encountering the positive terminal. So now D1 is forward biased, D3 is the reverse biased. So here the D3 is open circuit. So I can say D1 is forward biased, that is why it is closed circuit. So I made D1. I skipped D3 because it is reverse biased. Similarly, if I see this current, so this current will come here. Again, D2 is forward biased, but this current will go here as well, which makes D4 reverse biased. So now D2 is forward biased, D4 is reverse biased. So now current will move here, here. From here it will divide into half and half. So it will go here, here. It is a closed switch. It's an ideal diode. It's a closed switch. So equal current will come in the opposite direction, equal and opposite current. So I hope you remember, the current will produce the magnetic field which is transferred through the transformer. So magnetic field is cancelled by equal and opposite current. So how much magnetic field is this current making? Same magnetic field is the downward current making. So now the magnetic field because of upward and downward current would get cancelled out, and here I'll get the zero magnetic field. So because the magnetic field is zero, I'll not have induced current. So induced current in transformer is zero. So from here I can say the transformer is not inducing any current. So I can say V output T is zero, because induced current or induced voltage in the transformer, or I can say this to be induced voltage as well. So directly I can write that induced voltage is zero, or directly I can say V output T is zero, or I can say induced current is zero, which is not inducing any voltage at the output. So now coming to the second part, now I am taking again XT to be zero, but now CT is negative. So now when CT is negative, so let's see what would happen. So this is negative, this is positive. So now the current will flow in the reverse direction, and the current from here would flow upside and downside, which will make diode D2. From here the current will flow here and here and here and here. So now you can see the diode D1 and D2 are reverse biased. So here I can say D1, D2 was forward biased and D3, D4 were reverse biased. But here opposite would happen. Here D1, D2 would be reverse biased and D3, D4 are forward biased. So now next time I'll see the structure, the circuit. So input is zero, I am not making any input again. Because D2 and D1 are open circuit, I am not making them. So it's again the center tapped carrier. So the carrier is negative terminal. So now, so when I am taking carrier to be negative, so here I am having negative, here I am having positive. So current will flow in this direction. Here I have equal current in upward and equal current in downward direction. So you can make the current flow as well. So from here the current will be going here, from here it will be going here. So now again you can see equal and opposite current are moving in the upward and downward direction. So again I can say equal and opposite current. Again magnetic field 0. Again induced voltage would be 0. Induced voltage or induced current in the transformer is 0. So now I can say V output T is 0. So now taking the next case. The next case is when I am supplying any input to the circuit. So XT is positive. So from here I am supplying XT to be positive. So from here I am giving positive negative. So here some positive voltage would induce, here negative. So this is a closed circuit. So again here the positive voltage would induce, here negative, which induces positive and negative voltage here. So now I can say when XT is positive and CT is positive, which diodes are working? When CT is positive, the diodes D1 and D2 are working. And what is the output? Output is positive. So now taking the next case, in the next case I am taking XT again to be positive. So here I am supplying XT. So this is my XT. So XT is positive. So it induces a positive voltage here. But this positive will go here and this negative will go here. So here the negative voltage is induced at the output. So here I am inducing negative voltage when the input is negative and the carrier is negative. So when XT is positive and the carrier is negative, that time which diodes are working? Diode 3 and diode 4 are working. And I am getting the negative output. So now when my input is negative and the carrier is again positive or negative, so the diodes would get reversed. So here when I have negative input, the diodes D3 and D4 would be functioning. And when I have negative input and negative carrier, the diode D1 and D2 would be functioning. So the output, so let's see, when diode D3 and D4 are working and I have negative input. So here I have negative, here positive. So here I'll get the negative. So induced voltage here would be negative and here positive. So here it will be negative. And here it will be positive. So here I am getting the positive output. So the output would be positive. And when input is negative and diode D1 and D2 are working. So when input is negative and diode D1 and D2 are working, so here I'll get the negative output. So you can see now when the input is negative, here the induced voltage is negative, which is transferred here. So here the induced voltage would be negative. So this is my table which summarizes the working of the XT when XT is positive or negative and when the carrier are positive or negative. So let's understand this with the help of the waveform. So let's see, take the example that this is XT. So I am taking a simple XT. I am taking the sinusoidal XT. So let's suppose that this is my carrier. The carrier, I am approximating it to the square wave to get the ideal functioning of the diode. So now this is my output waveform. So this is T, this was CT, and this is output MT, modulated waveform. So now here my XT is positive, carrier is positive. So when both are positive, D1 and D2 are working and I'll get the positive output. So this is D1, D2. So this represents D1, D2. Now here my XT is positive, the carrier is negative. So when XT is positive and the carrier is negative, D3 and D4 are working. So this represents D3 and D4. So now again it will repeat, XT is positive, carrier is positive. So similarly the downward direction graph would repeat itself. So I am directly making it. So here at all the places the carrier is negative and the input XT is positive. So it is represented by D3, D4. When both are positive, it is represented by D1, D2. So let's come to the next part where my input XT is negative. So here in this cycle XT is negative. So now taking XT to be negative. So now when it is negative, input is negative and the carrier is positive, D3 and D4 are working. So here the carrier, first the carrier is positive. So D3 and D4 are working. I am getting positive output. So D3 and D4 are represented by green and here I am getting the positive output. So now coming to the next part. So here it is negative and it is also negative. So here it is, when both are negative, D1 and D2 are working and it is represented by negative. So D1 and D2 are represented by blue and it is represented by negative. Similarly, it will repeat itself. So now this is the output waveform of double sideband suppressed carrier amplitude modulation. So I hope you understood how the ring modulator or the chopper modulator is working. So let me summarize it. So this was my structure. Here I had four diodes which are connected in the circular type. So it is called a ring modulator because these are connected in the circular ring type of structure. So now the diode working is dependent upon the carrier because it is having a high frequency and high amplitude. So now coming to the working, when I took XT as 0, so when XT was 0, when that time I am not getting any output, so MT was 0. So from here you can see here XT is 0, so here I am not getting any output. So now taking the positive case, when XT is positive, that time the diode D1 and D2 are working and I am getting the output voltage to be positive. When the XT is positive, the carrier is negative, so diode D3 and D4 are working and I am getting the negative output because the positive part will go here and the negative would go here. Now coming to the negative voltage. So the negative voltage is the reverse of the diode. So when the carrier is positive, the diode D3 and D4 would work. So now here diode D3 and D4 would work and I'll get the positive output. Because whenever diode D3 and D4 would work, the input is reversed and I'll get, when I had supplied negative input, I'll get the positive output. And now when I have negative XT and negative carrier, the diode D1 and D2 would work. So you can see from here, if I am supplying negative input, I'll get the negative output. So with the help of this chart, I can make the waveform. So now I hope you understood each and everything which I discussed in this video. So I hope you don't have any doubts now. If you still have any doubt, you can put the doubt in the comment box and I'll try to resolve it as soon as possible. I hope you like this video. If you like it, share it with your friends, subscribe to the channel and push the like button. Thank you.